Recently, I received this Yaesu FTH-2008 from a friend who had no way of programming it, and I was surprised at the lack of programming information on this thing. Other than that foreign language one, where about all I could determine from it was that you're not going to be using the standard Yaesu plug, as this is 3.5. The gentleman had the programming cable, which is 2.5 mono, in the microphone jack. The gentleman kept pointing at the push to talk and the monitor button. As it works out, you pry this rubber out and there's a slide switch in there. You push the slide switch down and it gets you into the check mode. I learned this by going to mods.dk and downloading the user manual to see what the heck was going on. Because I have several DOS radios, I have this little box, and again, because this is a mono plug and you have to read and write from the same mono, I have a switch that in one the up position it reads the radio, in the down position it now transmits back to the radio. For the demonstration purposes, I'm going to download the radio now, which by the way is important to do for the first time. The manual stresses that don't just get the program that's empty, entering all the channel data, and then writing it to the radio, because you lose the version of the radio and a bunch of electronic tuning that's also downloaded at the same time. So if you upload something without downloading and modifying it, the chances are pretty good you're going to end up with a radio that won't work. Okay, now we're going to read the radio.
There, and you want to press space, so like that, and it comes on there. It says press the push to talk switch on the radio, and it has now downloaded all the frequencies.
After I've modified my channel data and I want to write it to the radio, I have to push my little switch down to select the correct segment of my RS-232. We have to push space on the computer.
We have to go F6 to write. So right down here, it comes up on here, switch radio to check mode, which we did. And now we're going to press space. Now we're going to press the RES monitor switch on there.
And it says load.
And now it says load. Okay, and then now we're going to press space. And it says sending.
And you can see the data at home.
And then now it comes up on here that it has now loaded the channel data in it.
Okay, as much as I like to have the frequency reading out on the radio, that's only in a check mode. You have to return the slide switch back up to the normal operate mode, which of course gives you channel 01, 02, etc. There's no way around it. The radio right now will receive okay, but it will not transmit.